When it comes to your muscles performing optimally, its heat is often an underrated component. An excessively hot muscle has a diminished capacity to produce force. The body can reduce a muscle's temperature by circulating blood to it, extracting the heat, and dispersing it around the rest of the body. However, this cannot continue forever. As the overall body temperature rises, the circulating blood to the muscle becomes ineffective at heat removal, simply because the circulating blood itself is high in temperature. Glabrous skin regions, particularly the soles of the feet and palms of the hand, due to having a unique vascular structure, are an effective region to cool the overall body temperature. Put simply, cooling the palms of the hand or soles of the feet can decrease the temperature of circulating blood. Based on all of this information, cooling these glabrous skin regions during exercise can cool down the circulating blood, allowing it to be more effective at removing heat from the muscle, thereby potentially facilitating an increase in muscle performance. An extremely fascinating study by Gran and colleagues examined how much heat impacts performance, as well as if cooling your palms could improve performance and long-term strength gains. The study comprised of three protocols. The first evaluated the former question, whereas the last two assessed the latter two questions. Let's start with protocol one. In one session, subjects ran on a treadmill in a hot environment until their core temperature reached 39 degrees Celsius. 3 minutes after finishing the treadmill run, subjects performed 4 sets of barbell bench press repetitions to failure with a 40% one rep max load using 3 minutes of rest between sets. In this session, across the 4 barbell bench press sets, subjects performed 36 repetitions on average. In a second session, subjects replicated the amount of work performed on the treadmill in the first session, but they cooled their palms during the run. Their palms were cooled using a custom-made heat extraction device that circulated cool water around 15 to 16 degrees Celsius in a vacuum to the hands. Later on, we'll explore how individuals may cool their palms without special equipment. As a result of palm cooling, their body temperature was on average 38.4 degrees Celsius after the run. 3 minutes after the run, they again completed 4 sets of barbell bench press repetitions to failure with a 40% one rep max load using 3 minutes of rest between sets. In this session, across the 4 barbell bench press sets, subjects performed 42 repetitions on average, 6 more than the previous session. In essence, the results of protocol 1 demonstrate how heat can be detrimental to muscle performance. Subjects were able to perform more repetitions with a cooler core temperature. Now, although protocol 1 depicts how heat can negatively influence muscle performance, it does not demonstrate if palm cooling between sets could enhance performance. Protocol 2 assesses this. 7 men with at least 2 years of pull-up training experience were recruited. Subjects performed 10 sets of pull-up repetitions to failure, the point at which the subject cannot bring his chin over the bar, with 3 minutes of rest between sets, 2 times per week for 6 weeks. Some subjects, throughout the 3-minute rest interval durations, cooled their palms using the special equipment. Other subjects rested passively. The subjects who cooled their palms between sets managed to perform an average of 13 more repetitions across the 10 sets every session. In contrast, the subjects who rested passively managed to perform only an average of 6 more repetitions across the 10 sets every session. Put differently, palm cooling in between pull-up sets just over doubled subjects' repetition performance. Similar findings were also seen with the barbell bench press. 17 men performed the barbell bench press for 6 sets of repetitions to failure with a 50% one rep max load using 3 minutes of rest between sets, twice per week for a total of 5 sessions. I should mention that the load used remained the same throughout the 5 training sessions, that is, the 50% one rep max load was not adjusted. Some subjects, throughout the 3-minute rest interval durations, cooled their palms using the special equipment. Other subjects passively rested. The subjects that cooled their palms between sets performed 62 repetitions across the 6 sets in the first session on average, By the fifth session, they were performing 86 repetitions across the six sets on average. Opposingly, the subjects that rested passively between sets performed 53 repetitions across the six sets in the first session on average. In the fifth session, they only increased up to 60 repetitions across the six sets on average. Again, palm cooling in between sets resulted in a significantly increased repetition performance over a few sessions. Now, one would assume this increased repetition performance facilitated by palm cooling between sets should also improve strength gains over the long term. Protocol 3 aimed to verify this. 10 men, who had reportedly plateaued on the bench press, trained the barbell bench press twice per week for 10 weeks. They performed 6 pyramid sets, depicted on screen, with 3 minutes of rest between sets each session. If subjects successfully performed 2 repetitions on the 4th pyramid set, the load was increased by 2.7 kilograms for all pyramid sets in the following training session. Some subjects, throughout the 3-minute rest interval durations, cooled their palms using the special equipment. Other subjects rested passively. The subjects that cooled their palms between sets were initially using an average 97 kilogram load on the 4th pyramid set. By the last session of the study, they were using an average 110 kilogram load on the 4th pyramid set. The subjects that rested passively between sets appear to have remained plateaued as no strength gains were observed. They were initially using an average 97 kilogram load on the 4th pyramid set, and by the last session of the study, they were still using an average 97 kilogram load on the 4th pyramid set. Therefore, the use of palm cooling between sets was effective for increasing bench press strength in plateaued subjects, while passive rest was ineffective. Collectively, the 3 protocols in this fascinating study demonstrate how heat negatively impacts muscle performance and how palm cooling can effectively increase work volume and long-term strength gain. There are other studies also supporting the idea that palm cooling can benefit performance. Kwon and colleagues had 16 men with at least 5 years of training experience perform the barbell bench press for 4 sets of repetitions to failure with an 85% 1 rep max load with 120 seconds of rest between sets. Repetition performance across the 4 sets was greater when subjects cooled their palms between sets, using special equipment that subjected the palms to cool water around 10 degrees in temperature, compared to palm heating, which was 45 degrees in temperature, or a neutral temperature condition. Moreover, the same research group carried out this exact study design in 8 women with at least 5 years of training experience. The results were the same, that is, palm cooling between sets resulted in greater bench press repetition performance versus palm heating or a neutral temperature condition, except for the last set. Now, in all of the protocols and studies detailed, special equipment was used to cool the palms. Theoretically, if you can access something that is around 10 to 15 degrees Celsius in temperature, placing your palms on it between sets may itself suffice. For instance, you could fill a bucket with water at a temperature of 10 to 15 degrees Celsius and place your hands in it between sets. You would then of course dry your hands before beginning the next set. Indeed, Caruso and colleagues found this method to still be beneficial. They had 35 individuals perform 4 sets of 8 reps on a leg press ergometer with 120 seconds of rest between sets. Greater average power output across sets 3 and 4 was observed when subjects placed their hands in a 15 degrees Celsius temperature water bath between sets compared to passively resting. Now, it's important to mention that you do not want to expose your palms to something excessively cold. Excessive cold temperatures will likely result in constriction of blood vessels, preventing the cool blood from being circulated throughout the body. A 10 to 15 degrees Celsius temperature is likely cold enough to reduce circulating blood temperature, but at the same time, avoid constriction of blood vessels, successfully enabling the cooler blood to flow throughout the body and extract heat from muscles. Therefore, excessively cold ice packs will likely not work. Confirming this, Estevez and colleagues had 9 men with at least 6 months of training experience perform the biceps curl for 4 sets of repetitions to failure with an 80% 1 rep max load using 1 minute of rest between sets. Repetition performance was similar when subjects rested passively or applied an ice pack that was stored at minus 17 degrees Celsius before its use to the palms between sets. Now, if you can get an ice pack to roughly 10 to 15 degrees Celsius, that should probably work. Perhaps you freeze it, but leave it at room temperature until it reaches a 10 to 15 degrees Celsius temperature. But I'm unsure how practical this is. However, another potential method is passing an excessively cold object back and forth between your hands. Although freezing ice packs may be too cold to make contact with your palms throughout the full duration of your rest interval, you could pass it back and forth between your hands. Doing this might prevent your palms from freezing up to the point of vasoconstriction, although I'm not aware of any data supporting this idea. Ultimately, if palm cooling between sets interests you, I recommend trying it out with anything you can think of and see if you notice any observable improvement. Finally, all the research in this video demonstrates palm cooling can benefit work volume and long-term strength gain. Unfortunately, I don't believe there are any studies exploring the impacts of palm cooling between sets on muscle growth. Theoretically, the increased work volume may translate into greater muscle growth, but it's difficult to say without research. Hopefully, we get future studies exploring the impacts of palm cooling between sets on muscle hypertrophy. In the comment section, for those interested, there should be a pinned comment going into more detail behind the potential mechanisms of palm cooling on muscle performance.